Before we do, I know how people love hearing stories from comedians complaining about their travel. So I have about a 10-minute story that I want to tell.
Oh!
But again, it's not the shouting out show. Please
boo.
Don't... Please, whoever that is, please...
Boo!
Boo?
Yeah, boo!
Boo!
You heard me?
What? Who's shouting? Who is this?
Come on, son, you recognize me.
Who? I recognize you.
Yeah!
Who is shouting things at me?
Come on!
Come on! Stop shouting and identify yourself, whoever this is.
You know who I am!
Wait a second. Boo.
Don't focus on that part so much.
But it couldn't be booing, as in you're doing a poor job. It must be...
It's a little of both.
But what I was going to say is it must be someone who's dead who's saying the traditional greeting of the dead, boo.
Right.
Is this Garry Marshall?
Yeah!
Garry Marshall, everyone! I thought you said shaman hand.
What?
Garry Marshall, Mike.
Yeah,
goodness.
Look, I know it's been a while. I'm sorry to come to you in the form of a ghost. But I saw you were in town. I thought I should stop by and say hi.
This is amazing. We haven't spoken since you, and I don't know if you know this, but you passed on.
Yeah, I know. I said boo.
The traditional greeting of the deceased.
Yeah, I'm a ghost.
How amazing. This is amazing to see you, Garry. This is incredible. We all know Garry Marshall. He is the director of such films as Pretty Woman.
That's right.
The Rest.
Come on.
Runaway Bride.
I bet. But come on, I did Valentine's Day. I did New Year's Eve. All those day movies.
Sure. There was a third,
I believe. Yeah, I think so. Mother's Day? I don't know.
I think it was Mother's Day.
It might have been Mother's Day.
Yeah.
The Other Sister! I directed that!
Ooh. But also things like Frankie and Johnny. I'm searching to think of another popular movie you've directed. Pretty Woman and what else?
Thank you.
The Princess Diaries.
Anne Hathaway. Dame Julie Andrews.
You discovered Anne Hathaway, did you not?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
I said, look, here's a pretty girl. Let's make her hair a little frizzy.
What was the process to do that, by the way? Was it just putting her out into a thunderstorm, or what was going on?
Yeah, we had to do that every day.
Had to turn on the weather channel in the morning.
Where is there a thunderstorm currently happening?
Private jet.
We shot it in the Amazon to make sure that everything was nice and humid.
Amazing. Well, you're a legend of show business. You also created Happy Days and Laverne and Shirley.
That's right. Mork and Mindy.
Mork and Mindy, yeah. Exactly. Wow.
Exactly.
You got that exactly right. Mork and Mindy.
Yeah. He was an alien. Look, if you don't know Mork and Mindy, it's about an alien from outer space. He comes down to Earth. He goes to Boulder, Colorado. He finds this, he's discovered by this nice young lady. They hit it off. They become friends, but then they become more than friends. And then they have a baby. And then the show is canceled.
What a wonderful story.
Hey. That's the story of showbiz.
It's the story of a lot of people's lives. You meet someone, you have a baby, then your life is canceled.
Then you get canceled. But yeah, I decided, you know, I died.
Yeah, you passed away a few years ago. Yeah, it was a sad, sad story.
Yeah, it wasn't bad for me. It was
really
fine.
You had an okay time with it.
Easy peasy.
Lemon squeezy?
Smooth.
Like Santana?
Featuring Rob Thomas.
I'd love to hear you sing that song.
give me a heart, make it real, or just forget about it. I feel like you set me up. Oh, no.
Oh!
My ghostly phone fell out of my pocket.
Wait, ghosts have phones?
Yeah, why not? We got everything. We're ghosts. We can do whatever we want. This was a big deal, though. After I died, of course, I went to heaven. I'm a good guy.
Okay, so St. Peter let you through the gates.
Yeah. He did.
Easy process?
No problem. I said, Marshall, Gary. And he said, yeah, you're on the list. Come on in.
Wow. Is it a big, long list, or is it like an
exclusive everybody's club? On it. Everybody's on it.
Everyone?
I mean, except for the people going to hell. It's not as many as you think.
Really? What do you have to do in order to go to hell?
I mean, you got to be really bad, you know? You got to want to go to hell. You got to do stuff where it's like, no way am I not going to hell now. Or be any cast member from the Bravo series Southern Charm. All express pass to hell. So I was in heaven for a while. It was all right.
Is it fun? That's the thing that it's like...
It gets old after a while.
It's like robes, harps.
Praising God all day. being reunited with dead pets.
It's so funny because like we're down here on Earth and it's supposed to be terrible. They're always like, oh, heaven's better. But you only have to go to church one day a week down here.
That's right. Or none.
Those are the choices.
Yeah. One day or none. Every week.
One day or none. That would be a good movie where, like, someone is either a nun.
Or they're a day of the week.
Sure.
What, it's like,
like
Pixar,
a Wednesday.
Pixar meets Whoopi Goldberg.
Right. Oh, that would be such a good meeting. I imagine they get lunch.
Whoopi Goldberg and Pixar?
Yeah.
Like all of Pixar.
Yeah. Like all of
and they,
Pixar.
They'll go to the Ivy, or what do they do?
Every employee of Pixar is on one side of the table. And Whoopi Goldberg on the other. But so, yeah, it sounds like it would be boring up there.
It is! So I said, look, I'm not trying to be a jerk here, but is it too late to be a ghost? And they said, no, you can do that anytime. You can come back if you want.
Really? So there's ins and outs?
Yeah. There's ins and outs. You get a wristband.
Oh, good. So how long have you been a ghost then?
Let's see. Died a handful of years ago. Heaven, hard to judge time there because it's eternity. I'm going to say a year.
You've been a ghost for...
I've been a ghost for a year.
A fiscal year or a calendar year?
Calendar.
Great.
And for the last year, I've been working on a new movie.
Wait, you're directing another movie?
Yeah.
Garry Marshall, a ghost.
That's right.
Has there ever been a movie directed by a ghost?
No, but there have been movies directed by people who eventually became ghosts.
Almost
do you
all
know
of them.
The legend of Alan Smithy?
So what is this movie? I mean, this sounds incredible.
Well, this is great.
I miss your work. I love...
Do you?
Well...
You seemed a little dismissive of it at the top. I'm doubting your fanship.
The sitcom influence may be shown through a little too much.
Okay, I wasn't asking for a critique. Yeah, I'm making a movie. It's easy now. I can do whatever I want. I have complete creative control, unlimited budget.
Okay, so...
We can use every existing place as a set because nobody can see us. Oh, the stars of the movie, they're all ghosts too. So I got a ghost crew, ghost cast...
Okay, well, what's the movie? I mean, this sounds... Are ghost cameras?
Yeah, of course ghost cameras.
So cameras can die?
Cameras that got broken in life become ghost cameras in the afterlife.
Is it ghost film or ghost digital?
It goes film.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Film that got exposed.
So you're just waiting for film to be exposed.
Happens
now.
All the time. In the early days, they didn't know what they were doing. There's tons of ghost film.
Oh, okay. So there's enough from the early days.
Absolutely.
Are you worried about everything going to digital now? There's not going to be ghost film?
I'll use ghost digits. I don't care.
What are the ghost digits?
I don't know.
Are there numbers that have died? Like, we know 1 through 10.
We know 1 through 10.
But...
And then it falls off for you after that?
No, but everything else is based on those numbers. It's like, oh, yeah, 10 plus
right.
add one of the first ones, one.
Okay.
But was there one like Flurby that we just don't know about because it died?
I don't think there was a Flurby. What other concepts do you think have died?
Are there emotions that might have died? That
what,
we can't access
anymore?
We're
back to Pixar?
So you're making a movie.
I'm shooting it here in Washington, D.C. It's called Election Day. It's a series of vignettes all centered around Election Day.
So this the first Tuesday of November.
That's right.
Depending on which election it is.
That's right. We never say which one it is.
You don't really.
We just call it the big election. Are you voting in the big election? I need time off from work to vote in the big election.
So what are some of the subplots? Because I remember some of the ones from your previous movies. There was like, oh, it's New Year's Eve and we want our baby to be the first baby born in a certain hospital.
Right. Yeah, that's one of them. We want our baby to be the first baby born on the eve of the big election.
So you're just repeating every plot.
Not everyone, but a lot of them. Well, wait till you hear this cast.
Yeah, who's in this?
We got Gene Kelly.
Whoa.
Yaphet Kotto.
I have always wanted to see them together.
Paul Newman.
Oh, amazing. HUD himself, right?
Marsha
Wallace from the Bob Newhart Show.
That's right.
Wow.
Clark Gable.
Seems like you would have led with that. I love Marsha Wallace, but it's like he'd be billed.
Hey, I'm not going to hear any word against Marsha Wallace.
She's great. Love her.
She's terrific.
Did a match game thing with her once.
There you go.
Signed something for me.
Yeah, and look how you treat her.
No, she's not here anymore. Or is she?
She's not.
Oh, okay.
Grace Kelly.
Grace Kelly.
Yeah.
Was she married to Gene Kelly or is...
No.
Hmm.
They were not related in any way.
What about Kelly's Blue Book?
Yeah.
Did he write that?
Yeah, he wrote it. Gene Kelly wrote the Kelly Blue Book for used cars.
Little side hustle.
You haven't changed at all.
Did you want me to?
He may be here or there. No, you're a good kid. I'm kidding you. I'm having
you,
fun kid. With you. It's good to see you again.
It's good to see you.
Hey. Don't touch me.
But I can touch you. You're corporeal.
I can be solid if I want.
Wow. Why would you be solid?
So you can see me.
Oh, right. Oh, so we can't see you when you're not solid.
That's right.
Whoa.
That blew your mind, huh? Yeah.
So the minute you decide, okay, I'm no longer solid, you're invisible. It's like glass.
Yeah, it's like glass.
Not the movie.
Although glass is solid. So not like glass. More like a ghost.
I'm trying to think of other things that disappear.
I know you are. It's a fool's errand, son.
Water evaporates.
Yeah. Does that help you?
Yeah.
It's like water evaporating.
So who else is in the cast? You got the Kellys.
Yep.
Double Kelly, Gable, Marsha Wallace.
River Phoenix. He didn't do enough comedy.
Is Hector Elizondo in this, or...?
Not yet.
Yeah, I didn't think so. I don't think so.
I hope that remains a conflict, for Hector's sake. I miss that guy.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I
did. I can't bring myself to haunt him. He was my best friend.
Yeah. He hasn't worked since you died.
What? That can't be true.
I think it's probably true.
What? You think I was the only guy hiring him? He was on Last Man Standing with Tim Allen.
Okay.
It's a successful show. Turn your nose up all you want.
I wouldn't turn it down. Good guy.
Good guy. So it's going to be great. We got a great cast.
Incredible.
Everybody has their own little moment to shine, and at the end, they all cross paths in the voting booth as they're waiting in line. Somebody's coming out behind the curtain. Somebody's going in. Excuse me, excuse me. It's fun.
What's River Phoenix's subplot? What does he do?
He's the guy who has to deliver extra ballots because they ran out of ballots. It's a big election. They had more turnout than they expected. He's got to deliver extra paper ballots to the voting place. He's on a bicycle. And he's having a lot of twists and turns. The traffic in Washington, D.C. He's going up one alphabet letter to the next. He doesn't know what's going on.
Is there a subplot where, like, Clark Gable is ballot harvesting or like 400 mules kind of thing?
What?
How many mules is it?
What are you talking about? Ballot harvesting, like 400 mules? What?
I'm right, aren't I? Thank
what
you.
What does he mean? Tell me what you mean.
There's a movie called That Amount of Mules, right? Where they watch drop boxes and see suspicious activity, and it led to the wrong person being elected.
Oh, I see. Yeah, he's not doing that. He plays a teacher, kindergarten teacher.
Clark Gable.
Yes, he falls in love with Marsha Wallace.
Why?
But she's married to Yaphet Kotto.
Is everyone the age that they were when they died?
Yeah.
To me...
Well, let's hear your opinion.
Well, it just seems like I would want to die younger then, so I could be a young ghost.
Well, now you know, sure.
Yeah.
But people didn't know.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mean like Casper age, but, you know, like in my prime, you know, like 4 years ago at 25.
But look, wait, you think Gene Kelly.
Is Gene Shalit in this
Gene
as well?
Gene Shalit makes a cameo.
Oh, I love that. I love it when a film critic is in a movie, like Rex Reed in Superman.
This is how I found out Gene Shalit died, by the way.
As a ghost.
He showed up on set. Said, looks like you guys are having fun. Let me in there. So, what?
We were talking about he plays a kindergarten teacher. Were we talking about that?
I think we got past that.
Gene Kelly, you were about to say.
Oh, yeah. You think he's a chump because he lived a long life and didn't die at 30 and turn into a ghost?
Is he able to dance around the same way?
Of course he is.
Okay.
See, it's not so bad.
I mean, you're old and you're a ghost.
True.
I guess it would be all right.
I had a nice life. I lived a long time. I had a great, fun career. Wonderful family. Sometimes I see you.
You said you don't haunt Hector Elizondo. Are you haunting other people?
Oh, yeah.
Who do you haunt?
Ron Howard. He deserted Happy Days when it was only in its 21st season.
And you took that personally.
I took it personally.
Fuck those kids.
Fuck that kid. I don't want to wear the wig anymore. I want to direct. How dare you?
Was he wearing a wig in those final seasons?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
No wonder.
Well, no wonder what?
I wouldn't want to wear a wig.
Well, you have hair. So of course you wouldn't.
Are there, like, Victorian ghosts with wigs up there, or are they all like, look, I'm just not going to wear the wig, the ghost wig?
What are you talking about? You're saying if people died in powdered wig times, not Victorian times.
Sure, whenever people wore wigs. When did people wear wigs?
Like in the 1700s.
Oh, you don't even know.
The 1700s. Revolutionary War. We come from the same country.
But when did they go out of style?
1921. No. Powdered wigs?
Prohibition?
Powdered wigs, I think, the dawn of the 19th century. People stopped doing that.
It was stupid, wasn't it?
They invented more hats. They're like, let's cover up our greasy hair with these hats instead.
They have the tri-corner.
Yeah.
Then they were like, hey.
Let's get rid of these corners. Make them all round. Work
Good
like
plan.
A charm.
Yeah.
Hats remain round to this day.
What about that stovepipe hat? Really, Lincoln was the only guy to ever wear it. Am I right?
A few people did. He really made it famous.
Yeah. It's like the Hitler mustache of hats.
It's an interesting analysis. Although I don't think if you wore a stovepipe hat, people would be offended. They wouldn't put you on a list.
Sure. But it's just unique to him.
As I say, he made it famous. He didn't say, like, make me a special hat.
Right. Although we don't know that, do we? Maybe he did. I
think we would have heard.
Lincoln historians have missed.
The one thing they never found out about this guy in the million books was that he had a special hat made. I want mine taller than anybody's.
But it makes you think, though, that, like, we could do that. We could design a hat that we wore every day that was different and unique, and everyone would associate it with us, right?
It makes you think that. I've dropped the concept.
Are there ghost hats?
Yeah, sure.
Hats that get thrown down the sewer or something?
It's always a hat that gets thrown down the sewer. Why do people do it?
It's a rainy day. It falls off their head, goes whoosh.
That's very specific.
Are there monsters up there in heaven like the It? I'm thinking about It down in
There's
the sewer.
There's a bunch of monsters, yeah.
Yeah? Wow.
It's too bad. It's otherwise, being a ghost is otherwise perfect. But a lot of monsters, you know, because a lot of monsters died out.
Yeah.
You know, there used to be Bigfoots all over the place. That was just the one.
Is a Loch Ness monster up there?
Tons.
Just worming his way through the clouds.
I'm saying, here's the thing. All the monsters that we have today, that's one of them. There used to be a billion.
Right. The Tremors, there's a lot of those Tremors.
I mean, I haven't seen any. I don't know that they're real.
What about Chuds?
Plenty of Chuds. Plenty of Chuds. Big mistake a Chud makes is coming out from underground. They can't handle it.
Yeah, that makes him a Chud.
It makes him a Chad. A cannibalistic humanoid above ground dweller. Gotta get up pretty early in the morning.
Well, this movie sounds amazing, Garry.
Thank you.
What kind of shoot schedule are you on?
It's up to me. We can shoot as long as we like. This movie, by the way, it's going to be 7 days long. That's the running time.
And who sees it? Other ghosts?
Yeah, or? Other ghosts.
Okay, that's fun.
We show it on a ghost projector at a movie theater over a movie that's already playing. There's a bunch of people, they don't even know that ghosts are sitting on their laps, eating their popcorn.
Eating their popcorn.
Yeah, but it just falls right through.
But it's fun.
Yeah, it's fun.
Makes them feel like they're back at the
movies.
Yeah.
It's fun. I'm going to premiere it at seven premieres.
Seven different premieres of different movies?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's going to be one theater. I'm going to say, all right, next premiere is going to be in 2 weeks. Come back. We'll watch the next hour or two of Election Day.
Wow.
You know who we got a cameo from?
Who?
This is exciting. George Washington.
Whoa.
Never acted before.
Incredible.
He's a natural.
He's really good?
He's great.
What about trying to speak with those wooden teeth?
No problem.
Really?
I mean, he had them for so long, he knows how to speak around them. You never even notice, except for the smell.
It's kind of weird, because he's the dude who chopped down the cherry tree, right?
Yeah, he's that dude.
But I was thinking about this
guy from the quarter? Yeah. The dude who chopped down the cherry tree.
Sure. I was thinking about how weird it is that two presidents have these sort of mythical tales about them where they were so honest. You know, Honest Abe.
Right.
George Washington.
Yeah.
You know.
That's weird. The two guys out of all those bums had stories where they were honest? That's weird to you.
It just feels like Abe Lincoln was stepping on George Washington's whole thing, you know?
But do you feel like these guys generated these stories themselves? Like, hey, tell everybody I chopped down a cherry tree and then I said, it was me. Hey, tell everybody that I'm honest. I forget what his story was about
the honesty. I know, yeah. I don't think he had one. It's just he was honest.
Well, then what are you so upset about? Making a mountain out of a molehill over here.
Gary.
Please. Call me Mr. Marshall.
Okay. Mr. Marshall.
Please, call me Gary.
Oh, Gary. Okay.
Your Gary privileges has been restored.
Thank you so much. This is an incredible, incredible...
Egg? Remember those
incredible edible egg.
The incredible edible egg.
The incredible edible egg. It's no...
Safe life repair, safe life replace. That's a song.
That's a song.
That's a song.
Do songs go to heaven?
Yeah. When people stop listening to them.
Oh.
Yeah.
So some songs, like the minute they're recorded, must go to heaven.
Cause... Yeah, because nobody can.
Yeah.
Remember when Chubby Checker redid the twist with the Fat Boys?
Sure.
That's in heaven.
Yeah, along with some of the Fat Boys.
Yeah. A good percentage.
Two-thirds of the Fat
Two-thirds.
Boys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is you rubbing off on this audience.
Chubby Checker.
Yeah.
Pretty slim guy when you look at him.
I wouldn't call him chubby.
Yeah, I would.
I call him Big Boned Checker.
Sure. Like, you know, like slightly overweight Checker, maybe.
I don't know if anyone wants to hear that. I'd rather somebody call me chubby.
I think it was a cute nickname. Like, oh, look, he's chubby, like a little baby.
You know where that name came from, the nickname?
What's that?
Somebody said, it might even have been, it was somebody famous, like a first lady or something like that.
Eleanor said, Roosevelt?
A little later than that, son. Think around the time Chubby Checker was Chubby Checker.
Who was Ike's?
Mamie. Okay. What is going on here?
Give him this a chance to
this
answer.
This is turning into children's theater.
Mamie Van Doren, though?
Mamie that? Eisenhower.
Oh, right,
Mamie
yes.
Van Doren.
Who's that?
She was some old lady. She was a hot lady from the 50s or whatever.
Mm.
Tight sweaters and that. You know
oh,
what
really?
I mean? Yeah.
Little, I do know what you
the
mean.
The little capri pants. That was the look back then.
I miss it.
Do you?
Sure.
You want that to come back?
Well, it's better than low-rise jeans or apple-bottom jeans.
Okay.
Boots with the fur.
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Okay.
So she said, you know, she heard him sing and she said, you're not like Fats Domino. You're more like a chubby checker.
Interesting.
And then it stuck.
It stuck. So my point, though, is he gets nicknamed Chubby. Like, it's like
right.
Slightly fat. And then yeah. Suddenly the Fat Boys come calling and are like, hey, we should do a duet. It's like, come on.
You don't see that connection?
He's chubby. He's
yeah,
not...
but chubby and fat, they have something in common.
A lot like Hitler's mustache and Abe Lincoln's.
No, I can't grant you that. I cannot grant you that.
Well, Gary, this is exciting. I mean, it's so great to see you. I'm happy
it's
that you're happy.
You
I mean,
I'm having a great time.
Up there in
great
heaven.
Great life, great death.
Great haunting, great ghosting.
Great God, let's eat.
Is
remember
it,
that?
I don't know.
Good bread, good meat, good God, let's eat.
Oh, yeah, that was from
that
like...
That was like Funny Grace, you could say.
Yeah, yeah.
Your mom would get mad.
Sure. Rub-a-dub-dub, thanks for the grub. That's
yeah.
Another one.
And she'd give you a little slap, maybe. Say, do it right.
Where, do you get to see Mrs. Marshall up there?
Sure, my mom?
Yeah.
My mom, my dad, the whole family that's dead.
Wow.
Yeah, it's great.
Heaven sounds... Like, it would be all right. I mean, you're around the people you love who have not died yet, or who have died yet. You're waiting for the ones that you love who have not died.
Well, don't make me morbid about it. You're not waiting for them to die. Like, ooh, I can't wait. Please slip in the shower.
I always thought it was romantic when those couples would die, like, a day or two, you know, apart from each other.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought that was a drag. You don't want to have one day of life on your own to hang out? Come on.
It's like, yeah, maybe get used to it. Like, hey.
Enjoy. Like, just to have, look, when I was alive, loved my wife, we slept in the same bed. Of course, you live together long enough, there's sometimes you think, what if she died and I had the house to myself? What would I do? Doesn't mean I don't love my wife.
Sure.
But your mind drifts.
Isn't it the same if she went on, like, a shopping trip for 4 hours?
That's not the same. You can't rearrange all the furniture when somebody goes on a shopping trip. Throw out some chair you hate. People notice.
That's what, those were your fantasies, rearrange the furniture.
Yeah, it's part of it. Don't act like this is crazy. People responded. They know what I'm talking about.
It's an interesting hypothetical.
Yeah, I'm an interesting guy.
But you're the one who went first because your wife is still with us, I think.
Yeah, she is. Good for her.
Do you ever get a chance to see her at all? Or?
It doesn't feel right.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'll take a little peek.
Sneak a peek. Did she move the furniture around?
She did. She got rid of a few things. I was surprised.
Really?
There was this one ottoman that I realize now we both hated, but thought the other one liked it.
That's marriage.
That's marriage! Marriage is, if you want to nutshell it, it's having an ottoman in the house that you both despise, but you're too afraid to get rid of.
It's romantic. It really is.
It's not.
Well, Garry, this is exciting. I would love to see this movie. I don't know.
You're going to have to wait. But not long.
What?
I'm kidding.
Are ghosts psychic as well?
Yeah, a little bit.
Really?
Yeah, but I'm joking.
You are joking.
Maybe.
I don't die tonight on stage, do I?
I'm having fun with you. I'm having fun with you. Metaphorically or physically?
That's the nightmare, to die on stage, isn't it?
I think it's the dream.
You wouldn't want to do that?
Have that wonderful moment where people are like, ha, 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 what? It's great.
They file out silently when they realize it's serious?
I think somebody probably calls somebody. I don't think they just stand up en masse, avert their eyes, shuffle out of the theater. He's not asleep, you understand?
I guess I was doing a hard cut to them.
That's your problem.
Editing.
You always do those smash cuts.
Yeah. You see this chandelier up there, by the way?
No.
Yeah, it's not lit up right now.
Why did you point it out then?
Reminds me of the Phantom of the Opera.
Scary.
Scary guy, right?
Yeah.
Is he up there in heaven?
What are people doing? I came back for this. It's gotten worse.
Yeah. Phantom of the Opera, though.
What about him?
How did his face get scarred?
I don't know.
We don't know.
Why are you asking me this? I feel like this is a question for somebody else.
Oh, right.
Yeah, oh, right.
I forgot. Well, Garry Marshall, you're one of our favorites. I miss you.
I miss you, too.
I'm so glad you're a ghost. You can come back and visit us anytime.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, Garry Marshall, everyone. Garry Marshall.
What's that?
I don't know. Sounds like it should be a song.
Does it?
Garry Marshall.
Give me a little harmony.
Garry Marshall.
Terrible.
Could be a hit.
Where? In heaven?
Just that. And it ends after 10 seconds.
Play it on the radio?
Yeah.
And now here it is. Number one for the fourth week in a row, Garry Marshall.
Garry Marshall.
All right. And now here's Dua Lipa.
Well, I'm excited to get to our next guest. Are you... I don't know that you've ever been on the show with our next guest. I think you have passed on before they started being on the
show. I'll take your word for it, because I don't know who it's going to be.
Well, she is a social media expert. Please welcome to the stage Francesca Bolognese.
Okay, I go here.
Wow. Francesca, I hate to inform you.
It's so beautiful. I love this city so much because it has a pizza, pasta, and everybody mean to each other just like me. I love it so much here.
Francesca, I hate to inform you that, I regret to inform you that we are, in fact, in the District of Columbia, Washington.
In Washington, D.C. Okay. It's going to take me a minute to digest that. I know Washington, D.C. I know, with the Monticello. I know, with the Mount Rushmore. I know, with the Philly cheesesteak sandwich. I know! I don't like Washington, D.C.
I'm sorry, but people can be mean here, too, sometimes.
I don't know. Everybody, now that I think about it, everyone was so nice to me when I walked over here. So, it's going to be one of those kinds of days, I guess.
Is this your new catchphrase? This is like a Rosanna Dana kind of thing.
It's going to be one of those kinds of days, I guess.
I like it. Francesca, you're a social media expert, and you...
I'm not an expert, Scott. I know about it because I worked in it.
Right. But you're here to give the audience some tips about how to be on social media.
No tips. No fucking tips. How many times do I have to say? No, say it with me, no fucking tip.
Don't encourage them to be
no
saying stuff to us.
Tip. No.
No.
Yeah, okay, we come back to that. Yes, okay, fine. I worked in social media.
But you have hints. Suggestions.
No, every time I come on, you try and make me talk about social media. I have a life, such a big life, so much bigger than the little thing you think in your little tiny brain. This is not why I'm here. Not to talk about that.
Okay, well,
I come all the way from Italy, by the way.
That's right. Francesca is Italian, as you may hear.
No, I come from Italy, the ristorante / marketplace in Century City, Los Angeles. I sleep in a Parmigiano Reggiano wheel because, as you know, I am a 1 foot.
That's right.
Doll. I am a 1 foot doll. So I come here today because my cousin. Whoa.
Oh.
Things are getting spicy in the front. My cousin.
Yes.
Cacio y Pepe.
Yeah, let's hear about this cousin.
Cousin Cacio y Pepe. He put me in a wheel of cheese and he wheeled me all the way here. So no wonder I didn't know I was in Washington, D.C.
So you were rolled in a wheel of cheese across the continental United States?
Yes.
How you feeling?
I feel so dizzy.
How long did it take you to get here? I mean, that's quite a journey.
Oh, 2 to 3 hours.
Must have been spinning very fast.
I go completely to sleep the moment it starts. Doesn't knock me out flat. But actually round, because I...
Oh, I understand.
Okay, but obviously I'm here today because we are dealing with a very big problem, Scott.
What is going on? Now, you are on social media a lot because you work for a company.
Yes, I work for Bed Bath & Beyond.
Right.
Yes, we love Bed Bath & Beyond, but it is in trouble.
I was reading about it in the news recently. It's and I don't quite know how to explain this story, but it's a meme stock.
Yes.
And its price shot up recently, and yes. Now it's plunging. What exactly? Yes. Can you explain it to us?
Basically, some guy named Ryan, who worked for Chewy Bar.
Chewy Bar?
What's Chewy Bar?
Chewy Bar.
Yeah, what is it?
Chewy Bar?
Chewy Bar?
Chewy Bar.
Like a bar that you chew.
Everybody know Chewy Bar. Yeah, see? Okay, everybody know Chewy Bar. So Ryan, he worked for Chewy Bar, and he also worked for GameStop.
This guy has two jobs.
Yeah, it's
so like just me. to make ends meet.
I guess. And basically what he did was today, he sell all of his shares of Bed Bath & Beyond, which he invested in, I guess, and the stock of fall, 40% today.
40%,
That's a lot of fall.
Yeah.
So we're in trouble. Oh no! And I am... I'm now on a mission today to save Bed Bath & Beyond. Woo! Yay!
So you're here in Washington, D.C. to lobby for Bed Bath & Beyond?
No. Why I'm here is to be on a PR tour. Because Bed Bath & Beyond, they love me. They love me so much. I was just working in the store.
That's right, you started out as a simple shop girl, is that right?
Yes, and I worked my way up to social media, and then they got mad at me because I was saying stuff online about the stupid people who are idiots, and then they demoted me back down to the store.
Right.
And then now...
Well, your original job was what? People would call in... Would they call?
So people... My original job is... people, let's say somebody posts on something like, I don't know, Instagram, for example... And they post about, for example, Bed Bath & Beyond. And they say something like, I went to Bed Bath & Beyond with my family reunion.
Family reunion at Bed Bath & Beyond? Is that like pre-gaming there, or is that the entire...
And we were all wearing matching shirts. And we had just gotten off a cruise ship. And we were going there to buy a bunch of towels because we were still wet. And inside the towel, we find a lot of tiny, tiny, tiny little hairs. Then my job is to write, okay, Miranda.
The person's name is Miranda?
Yes. For example, okay, Miranda, you and your stupid family full of matching shirt idiot psychopath find a lot of little hairs because you a piece of shit. Why you not take your cruise ship, go fly into a avalanche of shit? That was my job.
That was your job.
And I was very good at it.
Trying to picture finding an avalanche of shit, let alone flying directly into it.
Oh yeah, well, Miranda can tell you what to do when you get there. So, obviously, now I am working on PR tour.
PR tour. So they hired you for public relations. That's what PR stands for, public relations.
Well, they tell me that they think that I make Ryan made. I made Ryan mad.
You made Ryan mad?
Yes.
Okay, how did... This is before he sold the stock?
Yes.
Or, oh, no.
Yes. So I think I make him mad because I say something like, okay, Ryan, why you not take your Fred, the brother you do so much cocaine with? Why you no go into your bathtub and drown your friends in all the stupid beer you drink and die? That one was it. It wasn't even that mean. It was actually like, yeah, pretty tame for me.
It's pretty tame. It seemed like you ran out of like steam like halfway through.
But Ryan, he's a fragile.
Yeah, he took it the wrong way.
He's a very fragile guy.
Right.
And so that's why they think that I caused him to sell all his share.
What prompted you to say this in the first place?
He walked in the room, he said, good morning. No. Absolutely not.
And did you
not today. It is a bad day.
Did you say this to his face or you posted this online?
No, to his face. They had me in for a corporate meeting. I have friends at the top, so I go in for a corporate meeting. I talk on the little speakerphone. Oh, hello. I go on the Zoom.
This is
I
because
drink
you have...
a coffee.
This is because you have friends at the top. They allow you to do this.
Yeah,
they're like, hey, Francesca, come on in here.
Yeah,
you're my friend.
They let me sit in.
Right, yeah.
Yes. Anyway, where was I? I'm on a PR tour.
Okay, so what are you doing here on the PR tour? What are you...
Okay, so this PR tour is very important because basically we need to save a bit better beyond that, okay?
I hope you do, because now that I'm dead, I have more use for the beyond section.
Yes.
I used to stick to bed and bath.
Also, you need the sheets, don't you? But, I mean, ghosts.
Come on.
Sorry, is that a stereotype?
Go on, dear.
I can't be canceled for saying that about ghosts, can I?
By ghosts, yeah.
Oh, no.
No, it's going to be bad news when you're dead.
I have news for you, Scott. Oh, no. You have already been canceled.
I knew it.
Yeah.
Telling the truth too much.
Basically, what I realized, though, is it's not just because of Ryan sell his share, but then beyond the being in trouble for...
The last time I went into one, they stopped giving out the coupons, didn't they?
I don't know, but...
Or they're enforcing the expiration date on the coupons? Is that what I read?
Yes.
Yeah.
Expiration date are very important.
Right. It used to be you could go in and they would accept any coupon regardless of the expiration date, but now they're cracking down on it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because we are in trouble. Oh, no!
What's your catchphrase again? I want to make sure we get back to it.
No tips. Whatever.
No, before...
One of these days.
Oh, God. Yeah. It's gonna be one of those days.
Okay. Just want to cement it.
I'm pretty sure that's
mind.
What it was, right?
Yeah.
It's just gonna be one of those days. So. Okay, so where were we? Okay, I had to go. I basically realized that Bed Bath & Beyond is in trouble because of millennial.
Oh.
Because if you think about it, they ruin everything. Yeah. They ruin avocado. Where are they? They are all gone. They ruin the diamond. Where did they go? Oh, no. We can find them.
The diamond?
They ruin the being mean to waiter. They also nice to waiter. Why? It's a really stupid. So what I think is, Bed Bath & Beyond, they are trying to ruin Bed Bath & Beyond. Millennials are trying to ruin it. Because think about it. They don't need towels. They don't have a house.
I mean, do apartments come with towels these days?
They did in my day.
Really?
Yeah.
they don't need bed sheets. They don't have kids.
I think I probably didn't have a bed sheet for a long period of time when I was a younger person. So, yeah, I understand
that. Yeah, you know, so it's in trouble because a millennial don't like Bed Bath & Beyond.
Right.
So what I think is I am going to make Bed Bath & Beyond appealing for millennials.
Okay.
To come. Yeah, woo! It's so exciting. Yes. Yes.
How do you do that? Do you add products? Do you subtract products?
So this is good.
What's the equation with the products?
It's got to be one or the other. Either you add them or you subtract them.
I'm going to do a complete overhaul.
Really? Okay. What
complete,
are you doing with
this? No. Okay, so I make a list. You can't remember everything, right? You can't remember everything.
I don't know that that one's going to stick.
You can't remember everything.
All right, maybe it is good.
You can't remember. Okay, the thing I learned is millennial love nostalgia.
Everyone loves nostalgia.
No, just millennial love. That's why you have somebody name, I don't know. Huh? Some guy named Jared who love Harry Potter even though he's 47.
Well, you're saying someone gets named Jared because of nostalgia for Jared from Subway? Is that what you're trying to say?
No. I'm saying, why do you like Harry Potter?
Yeah, that's true.
He's 49 years old.
Oh, he aged 2 years in this example.
He's 55 years old. Why he love Hermione?
Jared, I'll be seeing you soon.
So.
What about people who love Disney as well?
The same thing.
Yeah.
It's a disease.
What should people like once they hit 18? What? Knott's Berry Farm?
Knott's Berry Farm.
These are local references.
Things that I think you should like are wine, alcohol, dessert that come with alcohol in it. It's a very simple. Grow up!
Yes.
So, I put together a list of things I think that we could sell at the Bed Bath & Beyond to make it very cool for a millennial.
And you wrote it down on this list because?
Because I know can remember everything. I know can remember everything.
I'm warming up to that one.
I guess it's going to be one of those days.
That's good, too. I don't know. Do we have to choose?
Do we have to choose? Do we have to choose? Number one, hamster.
What are we doing?
Number one, hamsters.
No, but what is this list? I know you keep saying number one, hipster.
Is it hipster or hamster?
Hamster.
Hamster, like hamster. The little rodent.
Hamster.
But what is it? What's the list?
This is the way to make Bed Bath & Beyond cool to millennials.
It's so simple.
Number one, hamster.
And we are tapping in, don't forget, we are tapping into nostalgia.
Remember Jared and Hermione. He's 60 years old, what does he care?
He's on his deathbed already. Jesus Christ. Everybody die at 65. Watch out. Only a few more years for you.
Fuck off.
So close.
So seldom say this to a guest, but fuck off.
Fuck you. Why you know eat a piece of shit? Because I saw you eat.
Why don't you look in a mirror, maybe, and I'll see a piece of shit.
I saw you eating a piece of shit backstage. Out of the box. Oh, yum, yum, I like this dirty shit.
Scott, is this true?
It's not true.
It's absolutely true. Oh, excuse me, miss, can I have some salt and pepper for my disgusting shit? shit. We come in there. Oscar, B, you is stinky in here. So I'm having my dinner. Leave me alone. Do you guys have any hot sauce in your purse? I like to have hot sauce on my sheet. So disgusting. It's disgusting. It's so hard for me to prepare. You're so lucky that I'm doing as fucking fantastically as I am after I watch a disgusting display.
All right, number one, hamster. Let's get off the...
Okay, so yes.
What does that mean, though?
Number one, hamsters. Every millennial used to have a hamsters. Yes, there's one. There's two. There's three, four. See, every millennial have hamsters.
And so you're selling hamsters?
So we sell hamsters at the Better Than Beyond. Every millennial have a hamster's name, Lucy and Sam, and they get lost, and they go, and they're dead, and your dad find them in the pipes of the house. Dead. Every millennial have a story like that. They love hamster.
So this is like a pet store now?
No.
Just hamsters?
It's a one pet.
One pet store.
I have a lot more.
Oh, okay. What do you got? Number two.
Number two, milk in a bag. This one is so good. Every millennial used to have a milk in a bag. At the elementary school, you see it in your little area on a little cubby, near your cubby, on a little rug, and you drink your milk from the bag.
Is this true?
Who here have milk in a bag?
Oh, okay.
Ah! See? Millennial love milk in a bag.
I'll take your word for it.
Okay, so we keep going?
Okay, sure.
Do you like the list so far? I had to write it while you were stinky, stinky, face down. Nom. Do you have any more diarrhea? Number three, parents getting divorced. Wow! Every millennial love when the parents get divorced.
So how are you representing that in the store? Are parents going to come to the store to get divorced?
Yes. When you get there, we are going to have many parents coming, signing documents. Oh, I hate you, I hate you. Sign. No, I want the couch. No, I want the shit.
Does it have to be the customer's parents, or is it just some parents?
It's that is up to you. I think if you want to bring a parent in, please bring them in. But they will be real-life parents, even if they are not your parents.
So it's sort of like a show that they can see.
Yes.
As they shop for hamsters.
Interactive right, experience. Right. Think about it. When you go to Disney World, freak. You are in an interactive experience. That is what I want for Bed Bath & Beyond. This is nostalgia. I am millennial in my old-fashioned times, 1991. Whoa, so nice here. I love it. My parents are divorced. I live with my mom 2 weeks out of the year.
Year?
I live with my dad for the other amount of weeks.
It's a bad ratio.
It's a fair trade.
I would go back to family court if I were the mom.
It's an even trade. Okay, are we ready for number four?
I think so.
Okay, ready? That feeling when everyone wants to make you Sporty Spice, but you want to be baby. So, every millennial wants to be Baby Spice. Why they always want to make you sporty? You don't want to be sporty. You want to be baby. You want to have the pigtail. You want to have the other pigtail.
From the pigtail to the other pigtail, Baby Spice.
Baby Spice. So this would, when you come to Bed Bath & Beyond, immediately when you walk in, who are you, Sporty Spice? The rest of the time, you're like, I wanted to be baby.
So you're not solving that problem.
You're just causing people to relive it.
Nostalgia. Nostalgia.
I always thought nostalgia was a thing you remembered fondly from the past, not just any trauma you suffered.
This is happy. Happy time. Parents are divorced. Everyone think you the ugly spice. This is the time of your life. You drinking milk from a bag? Your hamster dead in a pipe? What is wrong? I don't see the problem.
This sounds specific to your life.
No. Absolutely not.
All right, do you have a fifth example?
Neighbor kid who breastfed till he was 7 years old.
How are you going to... Like, are you going to reenact this with real seven-year-old kids?
Seven-year-old kid on his mom, Titi. Please, sir, can I have some more? Edward, Chicago kid. He probably from Chicago. Probably live on the north side. That is the least.
That's another catchphrase.
And that's the least. So that's gonna be one of those days. Can't remember everything. I don't remember the other one.
Oh, that's a good one too.
I don't remember the other one.
Francesca Bolognese, everyone.
Excuse me, I have a COVID.
You have a what?
I said I have COVID.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh, Scott, I might be seeing you soon.
Why did you bring COVID up here to the stage?
Because I want you to have it.
Thank you so much.
I want to give you a present.
You can't remember everything.
You can't remember everything. You can't remember anything.
Well, Francesca, are you ready for our next guest?
Absolutely not, but okay.
Do you like music?
No.
Why not?
Because why I had to be so loud and also quiet? Crescendo, decrescendo. Pick one, you stupid fucking idiot.
For someone who doesn't like music, you know the terms. Crescendo, decrescendo.
Alto, soprano, baritone.
Baritone.
More like a shut the fuck up.
It's a good burn.
Yeah, that's a good one too. More like a shut the fuck up.
You can do it with almost anything.
Yeah, more like shut the fuck up. Scott, did you miss your shit?
Gonna end the show early. I gotta get back to my shit.
You miss your little cardboard box of shit.
Shut the fuck up, Francesca.
I can hear his thump. Oh, it's growling, please.
I don't deserve this. I'm a nice man who puts on a nice show.
You just have to stuck up on shit before.
Gary, you like music, obviously.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock.
Happy days.
Yeah.
Why was the theme song changed?
So I could make money.
Oh, right.
Instead of giving money to Bill Haley and the Comets or his descendants or whoever.
So you wrote that song, The Happy Days?
I'm sure I co-wrote it.
These days are ours.
Those happy days. Those happy days. Baby back, baby back, baby back. I want my baby back, baby back, baby back. I want my baby back, baby back, baby back. Want my baby back, baby back. I want my baby back, baby back, baby back. I want my baby back, baby back, baby back.
Barbecue sauce.
Barbecue sauce.
Francesca, were you not bragging that you had practiced the harmony all day?
I did. This was it.
All
right. Well, let's give our guest, let's give him a little room to perform. He's going to perform some music for us.
Oh, fine. I guess I'm
excited. This is exciting. A musician.
You know him as a singer of several of your favorite songs. He was on the show once before, live in Atlanta. Please welcome to the show, Donny Gary.
Hello, Washington, D.C. Oh, you all look beautiful tonight. What a great feeling it is in this room. I see you guys snuggling up to each other. I see you two looking at each other. I know what that is. Do you know what that is? That's love, love for you, baby.
Donny Gary!
Hello, Scott! Hello, Washington, D.C.!
Hello, Donny!
I'm very excited to be here tonight. Wow! Wow!
Wow! What are you wowing at? The fact that you're here, the
beautiful
audience?
Beautiful crowd, audience, historic theater, the government.
Okay. You're pro-government.
Oh, yeah. Big government.
What's your favorite part of the government?
The filibuster.
It's fun to say.
It's such a fun word.
It's like a Ghostbuster, but...
Hey. But a filler,
hey,
yeah.
Hey, hey.
Oh, sorry, Gary.
A little respect.
Oh my God, are the Ghostbusters, is that the one thing you guys are afraid of?
I ain't afraid of no Ghostbusters.
The answer song. Oh, Donny Gary,
yes.
tell us about yourself because I forget everything about you.
Well, I know a lot of people in here have been reading about me in the papers.
Yes, that's right. You're in the papers.
Yes, that I'm currently in trouble for tax evasion.
That's right. You, the government we were talking about.
Yeah, they were a little bit too big for me. And they figured me out. And a lot of people say there's no coming back from being $5 million in debt.
That's too much. I don't know how you make that back.
But I take trouble... And it outcomes.
What?
It what?
What the fuck?
You take trouble, and it outcomes.
And an outcomes inspiration.
Oh. So in goes the trouble,
outcomes inspiration. And I hold that inspiration, and I use it to write music.
Really? Okay.
Go ahead and hit it for me. Oh. Every time you go to McDonald's, they charge you $1.50 for a soda. Well, did you know that if you hold on to that cup and you bring it back with you every time you go to McDonald's, you can have all the free soda you can drink? I reuse McDonald's cups, yeah. I don't ever pay for soda. I'm talking infinite refills of fountain soda. Two sodas for the price of one. Sometimes the cup gets moldy, but I wash it out. Thank you.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So you mentioned two sodas for the price of one. It's really for the price of none.
That's true. I didn't hold on to the inspiration quite tight enough.
Let that one slip through your fingers.
But yes, but yeah, I, you know, it's been a tough...
It's been tough for you.
It's been tough for me.
I mean, to go from someone who made so much money that you could be $5 million in debt.
Yes.
You would have had to have made, like, $15, $20 million in order
for that
to happen.
You nailed it. You nailed it.
Yeah.
$17.5 million.
$17.5.
That's right.
And you never paid any taxes.
Not a drop.
And you didn't save any of it because you could have just paid the taxes.
That's true. I went nuts.
What'd you buy with all that $17.5 million?
One boat.
Must have been a pretty big boat.
Huge boat.
What happened to the boat? Why can't you just sell it?
It sank.
When?
1912.
Wait, so you bought a boat that already sank?
I bought the Titanic.
What?
Now look. I sailed the same route.
Wait, hold on a second. You bought the original Titanic?
I bought a boat from the makers of the Titanic.
From the makers of the Titanic.
From the movie makers?
James Cameron.
Wow.
Yep.
His name is so similar to camera. It's like he was born to do that.
I was thinking the exact same.
I think we were all thinking it.
Yeah. I wasn't fucking thinking
what?
That, a stupid idiot. It's not even close.
Oh, yeah. Something smells like shit backstage.
Yes, thank you.
Was somebody eating a log of shit?
Well, there was a big box of it, but somebody ate it all up.
Was that you eating the shit I saw when I walked in?
Come on.
I said, who's eating shit over in the corner?
And didn't you see him hovered over the
yeah.
box? Please don't come near. No, don't take my shit.
He
no,
was but... seasoning it. It wasn't salty enough for you.
You like your salty shit.
Okay, hey, leave him alone. Leave him alone.
Is that too much?
I can't believe I'm saying this.
Thank you,
but
Garry.
Leave the guy alone.
Sorry. Thank you.
We're sorry.
I feel like we were very easy on him.
You're right.
But what?
But.
You bought a pre-sunk boat,
yes.
The Titanic.
Yeah, but I've been doing okay recently.
Well, that's good to know.
I've been going around doing some shows.
Oh, good.
Yes.
For money, hopefully.
For money, yes.
Great.
And I have been investing all of that money.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Really? Sort of like Jay Leno with his Tonight Show money.
Yes, he never touches the Tonight Show money.
Right. Is he ever gonna?
I hope not. That's what I love about him. He only spends his stand-up money. That's awesome.
Why, though? Why is it something to be proud of? Why is it something...
It seems a little OCD-ish, right?
I don't know what it seems like. It's like a rule that he made up and is proud of for... To what end?
I'm obsessed with Leno.
Really?
I love him, too. He's, like, the only guy I like.
Nothing like Leno's monologue.
I like him on The Last Man Standing. My favorite show!
Yes.
It was canceled, though.
Oh.
Did you see my
That's
friend
it.
Hector on there? You saw my friend Hector on there?
No.
Hector Elizondo!
Oh, yes, Hector Elizondo.
Well, Donnie, you've been doing some shows. This
yes.
is great.
Yeah.
What types of shows have you, like big, huge concerts in arenas?
Smaller shows, you know, smaller shows.
Smaller than arenas, so like we're talking huge concert halls?
I'll wander up near a trophy presentation for a Little League team.
You say you wander up there?
You wander up. So you're not invited.
I'll drag a speaker near a couple of kids getting best participation, but drinking out of
best participation. Participation.
But somebody...
So wait, so now they're judging participation trophies?
Yep. Yeah, you don't just get participation.
Isn't that better? Everybody was so mad, everybody gets a trophy.
Yes.
Now they're judging the participation.
Yes.
It's a step in the right direction.
It's good.
Amen.
It's good. You can't just be giving these kids things.
You got third place participation.
Yeah.
That's why millennials are so fucked up, because we all got the participation.
No,
this is good.
We can't do that anymore.
Wait, but Donnie, excuse me. You also said that you do get money for these shows.
Yes. People do end up tipping, and I take it straight. I invest. I take it straight and I invest.
You take it straight.
I take it straight.
That's step one.
And I invest. Yeah, I've been investing in a lot of good things. Yes.
What have you been investing in?
You take your
in
tips,
recently?
You go right to the broker, and then, so yeah, what are you investing in?
Yeah, well, I've been investing in brick-and-mortar clothing stores.
What attracted you to those? The bricks? The mortar?
Well, yeah, I love bricks, how they're stacked on top of each other and how they're held together. But mostly just the idea of going to a store. And getting the clothes.
Being around a lot of people.
Yeah, being around a lot of people, going to a mall, parking.
Right.
Trying on clothes in public, which everyone loves to do.
Love it. Somebody being like, can I help you while you're trying on clothes? I'm obsessed with that. I love the feeling of it. That's been going pretty good. I definitely sunk some money into fossil fuels. I think those are on the up and up.
On the up and up.
Yes.
They're not up and coming.
Nothing shady about those.
Nope. Those are feeling pretty good. Those are feeling really good.
They're on the up and up.
I actually sunk some money into bad quality marijuana.
You are what you said, right?
Personally, I smoke only stems.
By choice.
Oh, my God, you gotta smoke a stem. You've never coughed and been less high in your life. It's amazing.
That can't be all you've been investing in, because
no,
I worry
about it. No. I'm investing in regular milk.
Great idea. What?
Vitamin D milk.
Just regular old straight
whole
up
milk. Milk. A lot of new milks coming out that people are obsessed with. No thanks. I've actually been adding lactose to milk.
On the side.
On the side.
How thick?
Me and my buddies.
How thick that make the milk? Make the milk really thick?
Oh, yeah. We're not doing gallons. We're doing 3, 4, 7 gallon containers of high lactose milk.
This is thick milk.
Thick. Oh, my God. Chunky thick.
With 2 C's.
Warm.
Yeah.
With 2 C's, my man.
Are you supposed to high five? I don't know.
Yeah. He gave me a chop.
It's because his hands are covered in cheese.
But yeah, you know, it's going okay.
You know.
It's going okay, but like I said, I take the money straight and I immediately invest it. So
that's
I'm
good.
Still not
that's wise.
Doing, yeah, it's wise, but it's not been faring very well. For
really?
Me. Yeah, no.
I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah.
And I still am currently $5 million in debt. I said, you take in the pain, out the inspiration comes.
Out come the inspiration.
Yeah. Out come the inspiration, hold the inspiration.
Really? So you're working on new music?
Yes, I am. Go ahead. Well, no.
No, you're not working on new music.
Actually, I am.
You
I can
are.
Be.
Sure.
I can be.
Do you want to be working on new music? Have we talked about enough?
Yeah. I've actually, for all the women out there, I know you're looking for a guy who can get you online, if you know what I mean.
I don't know what you mean.
I know you guys are dating a lot of men that don't have internet. You know this.
I didn't realize that was on trend.
So this is a really new song. Super new. Go ahead and hit it. Oh. Yeah. Ladies, I know you're out there completely off the internet. You need a man that has a nice Wi-Fi connection, right? Some of that high-speed stuff. I'm talking about fiber optics. I steal Wi-Fi from my son's work, yeah. I sneak into his work, pretend to be him, and log on. Sometimes I have to wear prosthetics because my son doesn't look like me at all. Get in, thank Thank you.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, that's a new one.
Fake fake legs.
I caught that as well. I distinctly heard him say fake legs.
Well, how are you and your son's legs so different?
You know I got these little bird legs, Scott.
Sure, but what does your son have?
He has four regular legs.
Oh. He's like an octopus. But
my son's an octopus, man. That's who I bought the boat for.
Is his mother an octopus, or
does he look like Ursula from
his
the
mother is an octopus? Yes, he looks like Ursula.
I mean, you can understand.
Did you see the octopus documentary? My life was an octopus. Right. Yep. What is it?
My octopus teacher.
My octopus teacher. Damn, that was sexy. You can develop a bond with these animals. I didn't have sex with it.
Then how did this all happen?
They don't have to do that. That's how smart they are. They can look at you and get pregnant with your kid.
Where does he work?
Potbelly sandwich shop.
Well, does he play music there, or does he work the counter?
He works the counter.
Wow.
You know somebody who's at Potbelly's?
I know. Yes, I dated a guy who played music. You guys know what I'm talking about?
No.
They play music at the Potbelly.
There's in-house live music at every Potbelly's?
I heard that today, and I simply can't believe
this. This can't be true.
And a lot of Potbelly, they do have it.
Like
see, everybody cheering for me.
Someone who's on salary, the job?
No! Artists like us.
Potbelly's is like an open mic situation. You can drop in any time.
You can do it.
I've played there, of course.
they give you money.
They give it straight to you.
Yeah. And they have free Wi-Fi there.
They do have free Wi-Fi. Yes. Yeah. It's amazing.
Wow, that's a great song. I mean.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate it. That one's brand new.
And, yeah.
It's new words, but it had the Donny Gary signature style.
Yes. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Does he use his legs when he's making the sentence?
I had the same question.
That's the thing is, I think he'd be good on the line if he had four arms. But four legs, it's not...
Do they look like human legs, or do they look like octopus tentacles?
They look like human legs. You know how kangaroos can sit back on their tail? That's what my son does on his two legs.
So it's like he's in a chair all the time.
It's like he's in one of those funny Halloween costumes where you're riding a rocket. You know, and the fire's going down that hides your real legs and there's fake legs out front.
Sure.
But don't his back legs get tired?
Yes, but sometimes he turns around and does like on his fronts. He can turn his head all the way around.
He can turn his head all the way around.
He can turn his head all the way around.
Why couldn't he just leave?
And he's covered in goo.
What?
He's covered in octopus goo.
Octopus goo? I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, and of course he squirts ink like a motherfucker.
Does he get that shit on the sandwich?
Yeah, no, he doesn't eat shit like my man.
So he's got tentacles, like hentai.
Like, just like hentai. Scott loves hentai.
Scott loves it.
He's obsessed with it. While he's eating his log of shit, he's watching hentai.
This show has gotten worse.
Sorry.
No.
I blame the guests.
Yeah, I do too. But also you a little.
Okay. So do you have other family?
Yes. But I
big
mean,
family, small family.
Well, I had a girlfriend recently.
You did.
But we broke up.
I'm so sorry, Donnie.
I know.
What was the trouble there? What was the issue?
Well, she said I didn't have a warm house.
Temperature-wise, or
my house is no temperature-wise. It was too cold.
Too cold of a house.
Because I wouldn't turn the heat on. So. But I'd actually. Inspired a new song.
What?
It did.
You have new music from Donny Gary? Is this a premiere?
Yeah, this is a new song. Very new. Very new.
Newer than the other one?
Slightly newer, yes.
By about 5 minutes?
Yeah, maybe.
I would love to hear a taste of it.
Or
the whole thing.
Yes, I'll sing the whole thing. Let's go ahead and hit
okay.
it. Oh, yeah. Girl, you know how some women want to be in a warm house with you? Well, I can keep you warm. I promise you I can. And here is how.
I pretend to be part of minestrone.
Are you okay? Are you all right, son? Are you all right, son?
Yeah, I'm okay. That one's always hard to sing. Gets me emotional. I have been scalded so many times.
Sure.
Me and my date getting ate up.
Oh, so you've been consumed by people. Okay, so many questions.
I'm gonna answer all of them.
I'm gonna skip over how do you convince people your soup ingredients, and I'm gonna just go straight through. How big is this bowl?
Well, it used to be bigger, but I've lost some weight. But it's a big bowl. It is a big bowl.
So you lost weight and you bought a second bowl that was slightly smaller?
Wait, you provide the bowl? Where is this taking place?
I've got another song.
What?
Yeah, that one's hard to explain. I have been chopped up. Eaten after a hot date. My date was also chopped up and eaten. We were reassembled in the GI tract.
What?
There's an enzyme in your intestines that can reassemble the human body. They won't tell us about it because, you know, they don't want us chopping each other up and putting each other back together. It's too much for the population to know.
This is the government won't tell us.
The government.
That you love so much.
I love them.
Where do you find this out? Like Instagram rabbit hole somewhere?
Yeah, I go down a rabbit hole.
Do you have a song about that?
Going down a rabbit hole?
Sure.
I thought you did. Backstage, you were like, I got to sing my song, Rabbit Hole. I cannot wait.
About that one interesting trip you took down that rabbit hole?
Yeah, I got that one.
I remember you said there were so many good words.
There were so many good words. and it makes sense, and there's a reason I'm singing it.
It's a perfect
that matches up with my character.
The character of your human being.
Right, yeah. Right, right. Oh, I can only think one thing, and it's not good. Let's keep thinking. Actually, go ahead and hit it. Oh, yeah. Girl, you know how some guys like to buy fleshlights and have sex with those things? Isn't that sad? You would never catch me doing that. I fuck rabbit holes, yeah, yeah. I get down on the ground and I fuck a hole until I come home, yeah, yeah. I know it sounds nasty, but it's not. Please don't leave, I promise. I'm not actually this gross. Okay, you're coming back in, oh yeah.
They're just arriving. That's our show, everybody. Drew Tarver, everyone. Lily Sullivan.